We are going to start exercise 8.2. Now, first question. A man got a 10% increase in his salary. If his new salary is rupees 1,54,000, find his original salary. A man got 10% increase in his salary. He got 10% increase. And after that increase, his salary is rupees 1,54,000. So find his original salary. That means salary without this increment or without this increase, we have to find out. Now we can say that the original salary plus the increase in salary. So if you add the increase with the original salary, you will get the new salary. So original salary plus increase, which is equal to new salary. Now here we have to find out the original salary. And the increase is based on the original salary. So we can take, let x be the original salary. Then what will be the increase? So what will be the increase in salary? It will be 10% of the original salary. So the increase in salary will be 10% of the original salary. So the increase will be 10% of the original salary. So original salary is X, therefore we can write as 10% of X. So 10% of X means that 10 by 100 into X, so which is equal to 10x by 100. So the increase is a 10x by 100. Now we can substitute there. Original salary, we can take it, we already selected it as X. So we can write as X plus 10% increase. So 10% of X. So we got it as a 10x by 100. So which is equal to the new salary. So the new salary is 1,54,000. The new salary is 1,54,000. Now we have to solve this one. So X we can take it as X by 1. X is X by 1. So the LCM will be 100. So we can write it as 100X by 100 plus 10X by 100 equal to 1,54,000. Now 110x by 100 equal to 1,54,000. So 110x equal to 1,54,000 into 100. Now we can find out the value of X. X is equal to 100 into 1,54,000 divided by 110. Now we can cancel this 110 with the 10, that is 11, you will get it, and here it is 0. So we can cancel the 0. That means we can divide it by 10. Therefore, which is equal to, now look at that, can we cancel 15,400 with 11, 15,400 divided by 11, 1 time 11, 44, so 4 times 44, then 0. So 1,400, so 1 time, so it is 1,400, so 100 into 1,400. So the original salary equal to original salary. So the original salary is equal to rupees 1,40,000. Original salary equal to rupees 1,40,000. So how can you find out the original salary? We can say that original salary plus increase in salary, which is equal to the new salary. Now next question. On Sunday, 845 people went to the zoo. On Monday, 169 people went. What is the percent decrease in the people visiting the zoo on Monday? The percent decrease. We have to find out the decrease percent. So we already learned how we can find out the decrease percent or increase percent. How we can find out? So the decrease percent is equal to percent decrease, or decrease percent equal to decrease divided by original value. Decrease divided by original value, that means the base into 100. Now how can you find out the decrease? On Sunday 845 people went, and on Monday 169 people went. So there is a decrease in the number of people. So what is that decrease? That we have to find out. That means 845 minus 169 divided by, so the original value. So on Sunday 800 people went, Monday it is 169. So from 849 the number of people is decreased. So the original value or the base is equal to 845, then into 100. So which is equal to 845 minus 169 676 divided by 845 into 100. So which is equal to 676 into 100 divided by 845. Now we can cancel with the 5 one time. 169, and here you will get 20. Now look at that, whether we can cancel 169 and 676. 169, so look at that, 4 times, what is that? 676. So using 169 we can cancel. Here it is a 1 time, here it is a 4 times. So which is equal to 4 into 20, that is 80. So the decrease percent is 80. So we can say that 80% decrease. 80% decrease. Now next one. A shopkeeper buys 80 articles for rupees 2400 and sells them for a profit of 16%. Find the selling price of one article. Now the shopkeeper buys 80 articles for rupees 2400. So what is the meaning of that? The cost price of 80 articles is rupees 2400. Now he sells them for a profit of 16%. Profit percent is 16%. Find the selling price of one article. You have to find out the selling price of one article, not the selling price of 80 articles. So if you want to find out the selling price of one article, we have to know about the cost price of one article. But here the cost price of 80 articles is given. So can you find out the cost price of one article? 2400 divided by 80. So we can write like this. Cost price of 80 articles. Cost price of 80 articles equal to rupees 2400. Therefore, cost price of one article So cost price of one article is 2400 divided by 80. So what you will get? Rupees 30. The cost price of one article is rupees 30. So we can, with 80 itself we can cancel one time, then 8 3 is 24, 3 then 30. So the cost price of one article is 30. Now the profit percentage is given. So profit percent is equal to 16% profit. So we can find out the profit on one article. Therefore profit is equal to 16% of rupees 30. So 30 rupees is the cost price of one article. So we can find out the profit on one article. That is 16% of rupees 30. 16 by 100 into 30. Now 16 into 3, 48. So 480 divided by 100. So what you will get? 4.80. So the profit is rupees 4.80. That is the profit on one article, rupees 4.80. Now the question is, we have to find out the selling price of one article. Now selling price of one article. So how can you find out the selling price if the cost price and profit are given? So selling price is equal to cost price plus profit. So here we have to find out the selling price of one article. So which is equal to cost price of one article plus profit on one article. So cost price of one article is rupees 30. So rupees 30 plus profit on one article is rupees 4.80. So rupees 4.80. Therefore the selling price of one article is rupees 34.80. So selling price is cost price plus profit, and when you substitute there you will get the selling price of one article. Now homework, exercise 8.2, question number 4. That's all for today's class. Thank you.